In my laboratory, we use engineering techniques to understand how information is transmitted by the brain with the goal of improving the human condition. For example, right now we're working on four projects. The first involves understanding the mysteries of memory and how it breaks. We're working on new methods of deep brain stimulation for patients with Parkinson's disease and other neurological disorders. We're currently doing work that we hope will lead to new treatments for intractable forms of epilepsy. And most recently, we're looking at the mechanisms of anesthesia with the goal of trying to improve the safety and efficacy of anesthesia in the clinic. Our techniques include the development of new optical imaging and electronic methods to collect and analyze physiological data. We're also guided a great deal by the use of computational models, which we see as a way to state our biological hypotheses with quantitative rigor. This use of quantitative models to drive experimental work is a goal that's largely been achieved by the physics community, but it's really only coming to the fore in the biological sciences now. I came here 4 years ago as part of the USTAR program. This is a state-funded program to promote translational research. Now, without question, the number one attractive feature for me here was the quality of my colleagues. The people in neural engineering here and in neuroscience are just superb. But I also was really intrigued by the challenge of taking the findings from our laboratory and trying to find ways to get them out into the world more quickly. Since I came here, I took over as executive director of the Brain Institute. This is a superb opportunity for me, I think, to foster both more interdisciplinary research and more translational research. My goal is that in a few years, the problems we're working on at the bench right now will be benefiting patients.